Their Williams argument is stupid, doesn't assume the context of our advantage. Our argument isn't that the government will decide policies about space. Our argument is that they'll hand it over to space entrepreneurs who will do it separately. But it's also stupid because our argument is that they will develop things like low Earth satellites and moon colonies, not trying to make our cities closer together. This argument makes no sense. We're no longer in the context of Cold War, so the argument should apply. They say if you desire accident, we'll find a way to justify it. This argument is fundamentally tautological. Your authors desire a world with a bunch of drum circles and hippies, so they write a bunch of stupid shit proving that's possible. I answer their positivism argument on the framework debate, the hegemony argument, their displacement argument is stupid. The gold chain argument between you, which is pretty devastating for a huge amount of the framing of his arguments in the 2NC, where he says that we try and portray the United States as rational and then use this justification of rationality to say that other people are rational, so we destroy them. We actually made an explicit argument that the US is irrational, and when it starts to lose power, we'll lash out and be a fucking dick to a bunch of other countries. It means we access the argument, and we don't link the vast majority of the framing, which means he really doesn't have an impact argument articulated at the end of the block. We also don't think things are determined entirely by rationality. Also, we don't say that Taiwan and South Korea, that particular argument does not say that Taiwan and South Korea are irrational, so they have legitimate concerns with historical animosity and incentive to jump up in a social hierarchy, which are wolf reflections and idiots, is irrational and self-conflict. The permutation do both. First of all, the only severance argument they made in the block is we can't sever things out of the text of the plan because that destroys negative thoughts. There's obviously no severing from the plan to a C. Even if you think they actually said we can't sever the affect part of the app, there's still nothing inconsistent with the affirmative affect, and they're all their affect things. I even asked them what the endpoint of their alternative is, the one C cross-section. And I think this is pretty devastating to say that when you eventually understand those underlying affective things, then you have to be inclusive. He says, and Nick says in the one article that there are other ways of including people other than visas, but it's not provide a single example of what those forms of inclusion would be. The reason that the visa system is bad, as described by their evidence, is because people are able to reject certain visas and not let people into the country. There's no reason why the visa system would be bad in a world of the permutation is also understood our desire and change that particular desire, but they also don't conceive desire shaped reality, which is the basis of our rational choice arguments, which I'll extend in a second. They also say the immigrant, they say that people are situated as particular beings in the context of immigration. Piece of standpoint of epistemology evidence indicates this means we can't do anything because we need to understand the empirical and underlying regularities that cross all behavior, not to look at particular context and particular situation. It is true that people have different affect responses. We can't know exactly what those affect responses are, so we should instead focus on the underlying empirical regularities. Even if we're not 100% sort of right, we're more likely right than not. Or how evidence indicates rational choice might not explain everything, but it can still explain underlying empirical trends. Even if people were irrational and affect in the past, it's still an empirical cycle. Well, every time there was a power transition between a hegemon and another state, there was a massive war, and all of us listed out a bunch of those intuitions, which means their impacts are still likely true. They really don't extend an impact much of an impact argument to intuitions, which means that we risk a risk of an extinction argument coming in the short term. That's a reason we should not be able to overcome. We also don't lead to the Tea Party. Our impact arguments were things that affect the entire globe. We never made an argument about why we should just protect the United States. They constantly attempt to mischaracterize this argument. The VTL dissatisfaction of our Kaminsky evidence indicates the only way to maximize the value of life is to treat all beings as equal and therefore preserve the most honored lives. People obviously don't have any value if they're destroyed in mass and equal wars. We overcome these arguments. The permutation at least resolves the risk of this, but they do not have significant offense to point out the case. They say the consequence of the ballot argument first is new rules about arguments. The block or voting issue would encourage the same magnates. Wait until after the truancy to frame the debate. Motion to demand relief is no. Then drop the response test when they're unclear about the premise. The one seat also destroys education. It's late to learn, praise, church, laugh, offend, and debate. But even if you win, this argument still do have consequences to our ballot. Those who are debating about visa policies, good arguments, which above the 2C, also our fairness arguments, still reason why we should evaluate the hypothetical world plan on Sandos. And aside they say role playing visas fail, their evidence says the reason why role playing is government is bad is because it gives us the ability to deny people visas. We're asking you to give people visas, which means it doesn't really be in five. Then particularly, it's also still, the state is still relevant, even if it is true that there are other things that operate in the world, and even if it's true that it emerges from desire. The point is that there are still that still exists as it is now, and you're not going to change the desires and underlying affects of the Tea Party, which means we need to recognize and analyze those sorts of things. We still need to engage the state as it exists now, which are Elshin, limited politics, good arguments, still a way to overcome the visa regime. It's not bad. Exclusion from the visa regime is bad now. The critique, they really do not accept an impact. I've already made this argument, but now the framework debate, they really don't explain what the framework is. You should be highly skeptical of allowing them to exclude the 1CR framework argument. You should decide whether or not the plan is good or that policy option compared to a competitive alternative. Our interpretation is critical. You should not just evaluate this on a substantive level. You should evaluate it on a theoretical level because their interpretation fundamentally, that choice made anytime you can accept that we no longer have the right to defend the implementation of the plan. That means the question that we are forced to answer about the resolution of the 1C goes the way they make the argument that it's predictable because they just critique the state. Even if that is true, our defense of the state and our defense of our underlying epistemology has to start in the 2AC, where they get to start debating the 1 and 2, which means they've skipped 9 minutes of 1 and 2, fundamentally written debate in their favor, fairness, the prerequisite to education, and evaluating the substantive truth of their impacts. We don't have the ability to predict them, test them, even if their framework is predictable. If you accept that we don't get to defend the plan, it also opens up an infinite number of other frameworks, means you have to at least pause to weigh these things against the alternative. We also do have substantive defense of our framework. Our general sentence is not about statistics, but it says policy research includes a bunch of different things, including statistics, but it has to be relevant to policymakers. Our Walt evidence indicates that is what empiricism does. They also our pastor evidence and our Ashley evidence is really mishandled by the Watson evidence, is specific and fantastic. ask in the context of immigration and kids that we need to have pragmatic debates about immigration policy because we recognize that we can't just make the system perfect. We're not willing to make everyone love immigrants or wall acceptances. Not just about our wall acceptances. Yes, it makes the Hitler argument, but it's a pretty compelling argument, and it's supportive of our Lynn argument that even though in a world where you accept that people just make decisions based on affect, then it becomes impossible to challenge why there are things wrong. When Hitler comes up and says we should fuck up a bunch of Jews, then we don't know how to defeat them. We have to be able to defeat them with rational arguments. Our Lynn evidence indicates that type of thing is more likely in a world where we devolve away from rational choice and rational debates. Also, the affirmative is not to stop the war. Also, there are... We should use rational choice theory or how evidence indicates it might not explain everything, but it's all explained by our irregularities, our own evidence is pretty good on this question. It's the most problem in empirically explaining since if we provide sufficient empirical justification, even if we're not 100% right or 100% theoretically correct, it's still sufficient to our convincing. Yeah, there are Cunningham evidence, or Jody evidence is pretty explicit in describing the argument that our Cunningham evidence makes, which doesn't really indict the truth of it. If we win our argument that there are some people who fundamentally dislike natives or are going to backlash against it, then it might be true, but we can't explain why natives have those particular identities, but you are not going to change Tom Tancredo's superego, so we should still operate within this realm. Within this, recognize we have to have limited and pragmatic policies in order to prevent backlash to create networks politics. Their duty of this does not indicate this is wrong. It just indicates this might be used to justify some exclusions, but there's not a terminal impact without the group identification debate or evidence is pretty good on this question. Even if there are emotions, those emotions are structured by our underlying biology and have been influenced through evolution. There are commonly evidence on this question. It's badly better to account for the neuroscience. That's Newton and Seven commonly motivated brain research seem to be a second direct vertical descent to change commonly. Documents with some general sense of neuroscience is rational view of the mind, sees the mind, is situated close to biological principles, kind of draws brainful, soft color, the research made across the force of parallelism. Also, the Derrida argument, we extend all of our consequential arguments, we still are net better than the status quo. And as long as we fight a nuclear war,
3:10.
Probably always.
Where did you stop on Newton?
The Connolly argument I stopped right after parallel.
Which card is that?
It's the
Lynn?
Newton card.
I don't have.
No, just look at the text carefully. You didn't put a space between the tag and the previous card, so it just looks like it flows into.
Can you show me this? I don't know. Oh, shit. Okay. Okay.